into position one or position two, the four system and most probably the attachments used will be totally different. The crown in case number one has to move mesially and the tooth has to rotate clockwise. In case number two, the crown has to move distally. The apex also has to move very much distally. The tooth has to rotate also clockwise. This force system going from one and two requires different force application and will most probably require different attachment. In case number one, we will probably want to have an attachment that is giving us a very light force in this direction, which is vertical and horizontal. So the force is actually in this direction. So it has a horizontal component and a vertical component, which will both end up with moments at the center resistance. So this teeth will, this force, if we call it Fy and Fx, Fx will give us a clockwise moment and Fy will give us a small counterclockwise moment. So it's important then to understand the ratio between Fy and Fx, which means that the angulation alpha or the angle alpha is critical to get the correct moment to force ratio. At the level of the attachment, probably the best thing would be to have an attachment with a slight angulation that would develop a force that would tend to give us the correct movement. This force here will give us at the center resistance the same force F, and it will give us also the moment that we are requesting. Remember that the more vertical the attachment, the more vertical the force, the less favorable moment we'll get, and we'll have to compensate probably with a force couple applied in the plastic. So changing the attachment angulation may be beneficial to simplify the force system. End of part one. Thank you.